So we've got another email today, and this email comes from someone that does not want to be named. And their email reads, Keith, don't you think that if God saved Kanye West, that it would help the church more than a regular person since he has a major platform? I know you don't like Kanye because I saw your video on him, but I think you should be more encouraging and supportive of him. Imagine what God could do by using Kanye for the kingdom if this happens. All I'm saying is you should be more open-minded about him. So thank you for your email and your opinion. Now look, I have nothing against Kanye West. Like I said, I used to listen to his music before I got saved. He's nothing more than another lost sinner in need of grace. He just so happens to be rich and famous. But listen, what I will not do is I will not pronounce or declare someone saved just because they start talking about Jesus, okay? And to those of you who have this idea that if God saved some famous person, that it would advance the kingdom of God in a better way, okay, you're in sin. You need to repent of that thought immediately, okay? God does not need you, me or Kanye West. God's will come to fruition and by his hand alone. And if you know anything about the character of God, you know that it is his good pleasure to use the smallest of the bunch, the runt of the litter, and the weakest of the group, okay? And why is that? So that he can receive glory for it. You got Gideon's army. You got little King David. You got mumbling Moses who had difficulty speaking. You got frail Samson, okay? And you might be saying, wait, Samson wasn't frail. Samson was strong. Yeah, Samson was strong, but his strength came from the Lord. And personally speaking, I envision that Samson was probably some small, scrawny guy, okay? That's why the Philistines wondered and wanted to know, where does his power come from? Where does all this strength come from, okay? It's amazing how, if you've ever seen like the adaptations in the movies where they, the movies about Samson, he's always this 230-pound, muscle-bound dude, you know, big old guy, right? Listen, knowing somewhat of the mind of God, I think Samson was probably a small, skinny guy, okay? And I say all this to say this, if you ever get that thought in your mind that God needs to save some big name celebrity in order to fulfill his will, you better check that at the door, okay? Because that train of thought attempts to rob God of his supremacy.
Paul says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ because it is the power of God unto salvation for all those who believe, the Jew first and also the Greek. What's the power of God unto salvation? And that is the ultimate question. Now we get to the heart of the issue. We think that the power of God unto salvation is popularity in the culture. We believe that what God really needs is for us to be powerful and popular so that God can use our name to get the gospel out. That's why we get so inflamed and enraptured when we find out that some popular or powerful person is a Christian. Did you hear that so-and-so was a Christian? No. Well, he is. Okay. But do you realize how popular and how powerful he is and how God can use his name and his platform? Stop right there. God already has a name that is above every name, the name at which every knee will bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth. And every tongue will confess that he is Lord to the glory of God the Father. If God already has the name that's above every name, what makes you think he needs yours?